What's up guys, this is Ronnie. Welcome back to Tutorial 9 and today's topic will be how to get all the issues status from your Jira project. For example, you have a project or you have a multiple project but you want to get all the issues whichever is actually associated with one of your specific project, and after that you want to get all their status. For example, you have a project called A and inside that A you have 10,000 or maybe 150 different issues or tasks, and just forget about tasks, just talk about issues. And now you want to get kind of a export that what are the status of those issues. So how to get that? Because I'm also getting use case as a request. So I thought of creating this tutorial now, because this is already you have created more than 8 tutorials, so 9 tutorial is fine with this thing. This is kind of an intermediate tutorial, and because I'll be going to use the last tutorial code and I'll be going to add one additional part. So if you are not following or familiar with this playlist, just stay tuned or just try to watch the playlist from the beginning. Hopefully that will help you. Okay, but in this tutorial I'll be going to use the same code from tutorial 8, because that will require to get all the different issues ID for your project. Okay, and after that we'll do some page. And this is API doc link, how to get the issue status. So you need to hit this URL, like your domain contestman.com REST API 3 issue and the issue ID. For example, you have 10 issues, then you have to do some sort of looping where you will like hit this URL multiple times, and from there we'll get some response, and with the response we'll do the parsing to get the issue status. Okay, so that will be normal. So without wasting much time, let me just start writing the code. So this is tutorial 9. So what I'll do, I'll just try to copy paste the code from tutorial 8. Yes, tutorial 8 is going to give you all your issue ID. So if I run this thing, yes, see, we'll get all the issues ID. See, T1, T2, T3, T3, 4, 4 and 5. So what is there? And these are the issues, like 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So if you see here, I have multiple statuses. Like I have 3 statuses for to do. One is in progress, one is already done. So I want to get this like list in the form of export from my Python code. So that is the ultimate objective. And for that, first of all, I have to read this project ID, and I have to get all these issues ID. And after getting the issues ID, I'm gonna have to hit this URL to get the issues data. So this is a kind of two-way like a tutorial, and this part is already done. So now I'll be going to do the next part. Okay, so the next part will be going to happen inside this loop, actually, as I told you, right? So what we'll do, right, issue_key is going to this one, and after that what I'll do, I'll just write url1, and url1 is going to be this one, right? Only this part is going to be changed. Okay, so what I'll do, let me just copy this thing up to this point. Okay, and REST API 3, and after that issue and issue ID, right? So it should be issue, and it will be concatenated with the issue ID. So it should be something issue_key. So our URL is ready. Next thing is that we need to hit this URL. Okay, so for hitting this URL, there are something like this, right? Let's copy this thing. It's very easy to do copy paste. So request.get should be URL1. Header will be header. I don't need this one. Header is always same, and authentication is also going to be the same. Okay, and after that, just we need to do some sort of parsing, actually. Okay, so parsing is very important, right? So I'm just thinking what to do. Maybe I can just write print response.json, just to give you guys some sort of idea, actually. Okay, so it will give me 4 JSON, actually, because my total issue count, no sorry, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so there will be 5 JSON. So let's hit this thing, let's see what is happening. Okay, so the thing is that here I forgot to give this thing. So I always do this thing. This is normal. So if you get, see, I got 5 responses, right? So what I'll do now, let's do some sort of tweak so that I can just get the actual thing. So data will be response.json and like this, okay? And actually I want to get, see what are the different keys are available. So that will be, that will actually help me to understand. So maybe I can write print data dot keys. Hopefully this is actually going to help me to understand. Okay, so just give me one moment. I'm getting a, let me check this thing first, like what are the keys we have in the dictionary. So if you see here, I got this many keys. So let's if I'm not wrong, my values will be available here. So it should be data dot, sorry, fields. So it should give me the idea about what is available. So let's see, check what is happening. Okay, I just forgot to get this thing. So guys, this is very simple. You have to just understand the data inside your JSON, or you have to understand the JSON structure. That's it. So if you see here, there is something, probably, maybe if I'm not wrong, let me just search with status. If I get something with that, it's done. Yeah, I have something called, like, I don't know why this is not here. I don't know, let me just a bit below. No, I don't need that. I need actually, just hold on. What's happening? Yes. Let me just check. This is one. Okay, we'll just check the last one. This starts with here. This something, its status must be there. Like, okay. Not sure that is this. Okay. I'm just thinking, just hold on. It should be here somewhere. Or maybe, just try to use like this status, just see whether if I'm getting anything or not. Okay, yeah, if you see, I got 5 1 2 3 4 5. So I got status, and inside the status there is something called name, and this is actually holding my actual status. See, to do done in progress. So now next thing will be like this name. Okay, see, I got this thing. So ultimate job is done. So now let's do some sort of F string so that we can get. So issue ID is, and after that F string notation. So it should be issue underscore key, and the status is simple. This is very simple. That's it. So if I run this thing, I will get everything. Yeah, that's it. So if you see here, just this verify TTS1 is in progress. So let me just go here. TTS1 is in progress, only one. Okay, and TTS4 is only done. Let's see TTS4. So TTS4 is also done, and remaining 2, 3, 5 is to do. See, 5 is to do, 3 is to do, and 2. So this is very simple, guys, but again, if you are not following the playlist or the series, you'll not be able to understand, because ultimate thing is for this tutorial is only this part, okay? But the for looping and everything was already like explained and discussed in the last tutorial. So if you do not like follow the tutorial, it will be kind of difficult for you to understand this part of code, because you already discussed why this TTS, because my project is TTS. My project key is TTS. I want to get all the issues in from that project, and after getting all the issues, I would like to like kind of do some sort of for looping, so that for every issues it will hit the specific like API endpoints, and from there it should generate the valid JSON response, and from that JSON response just I have to like do some sort of parsing, and for parsing you need to like just understand the JSON structure. That's it. It's very simple, okay? So this is going to be very interesting, and probably I believe you guys are following the tutorial, because that is why I'm getting so many different sort of like question, and that is very interesting. Like, this is one of the very interesting use case. I'm actually personally like this, and I thought of uploading the tutorial immediately, okay? So whoever sent this to me, thank you very much. I just forgot the name, but yes, in the future also keep on sending me, keep on trying this thing. As I told you, like, just don't rely or like watch my tutorials blindly. Like, after watching my tutorials, if you are able to solve something by your own, then actually the goal or like target what I'm trying to achieve will be like accomplished. Like, my objective is not to make you guys watch my videos. My objective is to like give you guys some sort of intuition, so that you guys can go ahead and learn something else from my video tutorials. That's it, okay? So enough of talking, guys. We'll conclude the video now, but please do some sort of feedback for my videos, so that I can create some more like quality content. It will be like beneficial for both of us, right? So that's it, guys. We'll see you in the next video. Till then, take care, goodbye, and have a nice day.